Hello and welcome to WPKlik's YouTube channel. Today we're going to show you how to add and use an excellent calendar plugin for WordPress called My Calendar Plugin. After you've installed and activated the plugin, you'll notice three new things that appeared in your backend. The My Calendar page appears in Pages, the My Calendar option appears in the Dashboard menu, and the Calendar widget appears in your Widgets. To access the My Calendar page, head over to your Pages. Right now, it's only a blank calendar. There are no events, as we haven't made any yet. A quick look at the default structure shows us that there is a header at the top. Here we can pick how we want to display our dates, and we can also go directly to the desired date. The calendar itself is not clickable, and below there's the bottom navigation where we can select an event category. The print option is also there. Note that, unless you change something, the default category for events is general. The plugin itself comes with several different calendar themes. Theme options can be found in Style Editor settings. We have used the 2018 CSS style. The My Calendar page can be treated like any other page in your backend. You can add other content to it as well. It doesn't have to be just the calendar. What's important to note here is that we have a calendar shortcode. This allows us to copy the calendar and use it on some other page. For instance, maybe you want your calendar to appear on your homepage or a separately built events page. Thanks to the shortcode, you can place the calendar anywhere you want. Let's see how to add events using the plugin. Head over to My Calendar and click on Add New Event. After creating your event, the first thing to do is to add a title. The title appears in the calendar as the first information about your event that your visitors will see, so obviously it's very important. The next thing to add is the event description. For example, if you're hosting an open-air concert, you want to let everyone know who's playing, how many performers, who's the opening act, what kind of music, and so on. The third item here is the event category. We haven't made any custom categories yet, so the default one is general. Of course, you'll need to change this because your event is a concert and it's always a good idea to be specific. The next thing to add to your event is the date. The plugin allows you to set a specific date and time your event will take place. In case it's a multi-date event, something that takes place for 5 days in a row, for example a theater play, you won't have to create 5 separate events. Instead, just mark the first and the last day of the event. The process is similar for a recurring event. For example, for a show that takes place each Friday for 3 consecutive weeks, you won't have to make 3 separate events. Instead, you'll just add a repetition pattern, specifying how many times it repeats at which intervals. For example, it repeats 1 time every 3 weeks. Events can also repeat monthly or annually, whatever works for you. Another great thing about the My Calendar plugin is that you can add an image to the event, and also a link if your event is listed and described as some other online location. Here you can also add event access and event location, but more on that a bit later. Once you've set everything, don't forget to hit publish. And now your calendar has its first event. You'll notice it's yellow and that the category general is also marked with yellow because that's your default category. Clicking on the event opens a window with the additional information we have put in. There's the information on time, the image, and the description. Clicking on More Information takes the visitor to the link you have provided, and clicking on Read More opens the event as a separate page. If you feel like you don't need all this, you can change it in My Calendar settings, where you can also have the possibility of adding other information and content, such as maps. Editing an existing event is also quite easy. Just head over to My Calendar and click on Manage Events. Here you find all your events. Just click on the one you want to edit and change what you need to change. Also worth mentioning here is the Events Group option, located just next to the Manage Events in your menu. This option allows you to change a feature or an attribute of a group of events. For example, if you want to change the category for 15 events, just check the ones you want and assign it a desired category that will apply to them all. Let's see now how to add our categories. For easier event management, it's recommended to group them in categories, for example concerts. To do that, you'll need to add a concert category, and then later you can add others for other kinds of events you're hosting, like theater plays, shows, and so on. Go to My Calendar and click on Manage Categories. Now all you need to do is add a name and a color for your category. The color will be used for every event in your calendar that falls into this category. Also check any of the fields that match your event, private category, default category, or holiday. You can also edit your categories, change their titles and colors, as you will certainly do for the default or general category. We have changed the color and the title for your event, and now it looks like this. As for adding the event location, we add it by entering the specific event, but before that we need to actually create a location and then apply it under the event. To do this, go to My Calendar, click on Manage Location, and then on Add New. Here you'll find all the fields required for properly defining a definition, such as the postal code, city, street, country, etc. The name of the location is particularly important, as you will use it to call the specific information from the event using the name of the location. Only after we have successfully created a location, we can actually add it to the event. Of course, the same location will be used for all of your events taking place at the same venue. Let's move on to some customization options. My Calendar plugin by default creates a calendar in a certain style, which you will most likely want to change. Fortunately, there are plenty of customization options here, so you can experiment to make the calendar more fitting to your overall website style. Go to My Calendar and click on Style Editor. Right here at the beginning, you'll find a CSS editor in which you can change some of the settings, but unless you're skilled in this sort of thing, this is better if left untouched. Some basic customization options are offered below the CSS editor, in which you can pick the main colors for your calendar. You can play around with colors here and find the color scheme that fits your website style visually. As we mentioned earlier, you have your choice of available themes you can use for your calendar. They are located right here, to the right of the Style Editor screen. Each theme has its style settings that you can customize. Let's move on to My Calendar widgets. After installing the My Calendar plugin, you will notice Calendar among your widgets as a new addition to the ones you're already using. It's often a good idea to place the calendar in the sidebar or the footer of your WordPress website. This plugin allows you to do so the easy way, in addition to other useful things it can do. With My Calendar, you have 5 different widget types available for your calendar. To check them out, go to Appearance and click on Widgets. Event Filter allows your visitors to search events per specific criteria. This may include locations, categories, or accessibility features. Simple Event Search is very simple, just as the name suggests. It allows your visitors to perform a simple event search. The Upcoming Events widget is used to announce upcoming shows, plays, meetups, or any other event you may want to organize. Here you can set the number of events you want to be displayed, the category, the location, and so on. Mini Calendar is another useful widget which displays events based on certain criteria. And today's events displays the events on a given day. You can also set a custom text that will be displayed on days when there are no events. The last thing we want to show you about this calendar plugin for WordPress are the My Calendar settings. To access them, go to My Calendar, click on Settings, and then on the Output tab. Here, for instance, you can rearrange or reorder calendar layout in case you're not happy with this current field structure. You can also customize your single event, for example, by adding a map. A map is always a great addition to any site simply because you want people to be able to find your venue easily. It's all very simple, just set some time aside to look around the widget in your backend and fix everything just the way you want. Also, if you know your way around CSS, you can easily change things like button color, button hover color, button navigation, and so on. You will find examples of code and detailed description of how it's done if you follow the link in the description of this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.